Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you radar cross section of targets in complete detail. First of all, I'll be explaining you basics of radar cross section of target. See, in my earlier videos, I have derived radar range equation. That radar range equation that was based on cross section of target. Cross section of target is sigma. So if you calculate maximum range of radar, then that is purely based on this sigma, that is cross section of target. You can say maximum range that is proportional to sigma to the power 1/4. I have derived this equation in my earlier videos, right? So you can say maximum range of radar that is directly proportional to cross section of the target to the power 1/4. Now here question is how to identify cross section of the target. Usually you may say like you are having one object. Let us say you are having square object. Now with square object, you can say area is length into width. But here cross section of the target is not calculated in that way. Here cross section of the target that is being calculated based on how much energy that is getting reflected by the target. So here cross section of the target that has been defined based on property of scattering of energy from the target. If you want to calculate cross section of the target, then basic equation is how much power that is getting reflected towards source per unit solid angle divided by incident power density per 4 pi. So here cross section of the target that we calculate based on how much energy is getting reflected by that target per unit solid angle divided by how much power density per 4 pi is there, right? So here, see, based on amount of reflected energy, cross section of the target is there, right? If you want to calculate cross section of the target, then one more equation is there, that is limit r tends to infinite, where r is range. And here we need to take limit of 4 pi r square into er by ei mod of square. So here you can observe here ER that is reflected energy at radar and EI that is incident energy at target. So based on this equation, we can identify cross section of the target. So here cross section of the target that is not directly based on how exactly object is having cross sectional area which is viewed by the radar. Here cross section of the target that is purely based on how much energy that is getting reflected towards radar, right? Here there are few interesting case studies that I'm going to explain you, which will explain you how exactly cross section of the target that has been determined over here. So here first of all you need to understand how reflected energy is there from the target. See, reflected energy from the target is based on scattering and diffraction. So here you need to understand first what is scattering and what is diffraction. See, in radar engineering, usually we use these two words interchangeably, but still you need to know the difference in between scattering and diffraction. If you want to understand scattering, then scattering is the difference in between total field in the presence of object and the field if object is absent. So if you want to calculate scattering, then you can calculate that as per this. You see, amount of field in the presence of object minus amount of field in the absence of object. So that is what basically difference in between energy if object is present and object is absent. But if you want to calculate what is diffraction, then diffraction is amount of total field in the presence of object. Usually in radar engineering, we use scattering and diffraction interchangeably, right? But one should know the basic difference in between scattering and diffraction in radar engineering. If you want to understand how exactly that is happening, then you see here we are having one object where incident energy that is happening in this direction towards object. So because of object, there will be reflection of energy, and this reflection of energy that is happening because of scattering, or you can say diffraction, right? So based on reflected energy towards the radar, we can identify cross section of the target. Now how exactly property is there Let us try to understand that by considering radar cross section for simple sphere. So right now we are considering our target is simple sphere. You can observe here we are having simple sphere which is having radius a. Now if you carefully observe, on x-axis we have circumference per wavelength. So here circumference is how much? 2 pi a divided by wavelength, that is there on x-axis. And on y-axis we have cross section of the target divided by pi a square. And if you observe the characteristic, then that is happening like this. Now in this characteristic we are having three essential regions. First region is Rayleigh region, second is Mia or resonance region, and third one is optical region. Let me explain you all those regions one by one. That will give you more clarity about how objects are identified over here. See here, first region, that is Rayleigh region. In Rayleigh region, see, value of wavelength, that is very high, and based on this horizontal axis you can say 2 pi a by lambda, that is very lower than unity. You can observe over here, even see here 2 pi a by lambda, that is very lower than 1. This region belongs to Rayleigh region. In this region, if you observe cross section of the target per pi a square, so that is having lower value over here, right? So how to utilize this region? See, this region that belongs to lower frequency. You can observe here we are having lower wavelength, right? So this region that belongs to lower frequency. Here, this region that belongs to smaller size of target. See here, sigma by pi a square, that is small over here. That is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 2 to 10 to the power minus 1. So in this region, target size, that is small, right? Now third point that you can note, that is here radar cross section appears lower than pi a square. Usually if you have target which is having radius of a, then how much area should appear over here? Pi a square, right? But in this region, antenna at radar will be observing that your cross section of the target, that is lower than pi a square. The reason is this characteristic is there with Rayleigh region. And see, in this region we will be identifying smaller size of target, for example raindrops, and that is also used in geology where meteorological particles, that has been observed in this region. So in geology, usually at very low frequency we operate with radar to identify minerals, right? Now second region is Mia region or resonance region. See, in this region 2 pi a by lambda, that is nearer to 1. So over here at 1 you can say we have Mia region, and nearer to this also referred as Mia region, right? That is also referred as resonance region. See, with this region there are a few basic characteristics that one should know. Here see, this region is maximum at 2 pi a is equals to lambda. So you can observe at this point 2 pi a by lambda, that is equals to 1, and at this region we have Mia region. So maximum value that is happening at 2 pi a by lambda, and nearer to 2 pi a by lambda we have Mia region. In this region you can observe here characteristic is like oscillatory characteristic, right? So in this region cross section is oscillatory. So as and when cross section is observed at radar side, and as if it is there in resonance region, at that time there is oscillatory nature of object, right? Here you'll be observing we are identifying moderate size of target. So this region, that we use it for moderate size of target. Let me give you one example. See, drone, that is one example for this region of operation for identification of target, right? Now third region, that is optical region. See, in optical region you will be observing this 2 pi a by lambda, that is very greater than 1, right? 2 pi a by lambda, that is very greater than 1 for optical region. Now in optical region, you will be observing this sigma by pi a square that is close to unity over here, right? So in optical region, 2 pi a by lambda, that is very greater than 1, that belongs to lower wavelength, means higher frequency, right? So here radar functions at higher frequency as this 2 pi a by lambda, that is very greater than 1, where we have lower wavelengths over here and radar is operating at higher frequency. This region belongs to larger size of target. So here you will be observing target is appearing as per its size. Why? The reason is, you see, sigma by pi a square, that is close to unity, where we are identifying larger size of target, right? So actual size that is appearing over here in this region. So actual size that is appearing in optical region only. See, over here we are having oscillatory region, and in Rayleigh region, target appears smaller than its actual size, right? So this region belongs to larger size of target. Here cross section becomes pi a square. So here cross section becomes pi a square. That is what actual cross section, which is visible for, which is visible by naked eyes, right? Like if you observe sphere, then you will be observing that cross section by pi a square only, right? That is happening in optical region, and that is possible with larger size of object. It is not possible with smaller size of object, right? Let me give you some examples, like aircrafts and ships, which is having this optical region over here. So to identify larger size of object, we should be using frequencies in terms of gigahertz, right? Like if you want to identify aircrafts, aeroplane, ships, in that case we will be operating in terms of gigahertz of frequency. If you want to identify smaller size of object like drone, at that time we should be going towards UHF and VHF frequency. And if you want to identify raindrops, or if you want to identify metallurgical particles, like in geology we try to identify natural resources inside earth surface, at that time we use very low frequency, right? In terms of megahertz of frequency, we use radar. So that is how different cross sections are there with different operating frequencies with radar system. I hope you have enjoyed this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.